When it comes to gauging the health of your heart, pushing it to the limit can tell you a lot. That's the basic idea behind a cardiac stress test, which forces your heart to pump harder and faster to see how it functions at peak demand. Why would someone need to have one, and kind of what's the purpose behind it?
The heart, even with blockages in the arteries, most of the time, can meet its metabolic demand, meaning it can get enough blood supply to supply the muscle and not have any issues. When it becomes a problem is when you put some stress on the heart and it requires more blood to perform, it sees itself as lacking in oxygen or lacking in nutrients. And this is when you start having the chest pain symptoms or the shortness of breath. We're trying to simulate that. We're trying actually to get you to a point where we can figure out how much the heart is at risk from a blockage, or how tight is this blockage and how significant. So it's different how we are seeing it by camera versus how the heart is seeing that blockage.
What actually happens during a stress test?
So these are not like the stress tests you see at the gym when people are like just running on the treadmill and watching TV and all this stuff, although we can do that. This is a very controlled environment. A person is screened carefully before they arrive to the stress test, usually ordered by a physician who's suspecting something. And that equipment, it depends on the type of stress test, can monitor the heart rate, the blood pressure, the ECG, the electric activity of the heart, or it can monitor more than that. Sometimes you see these stress tests where patients are wearing a mask. This is basically for oxygenation and demand and CO2 and all these things. This we do it when people with heart failure or people with extreme athletes are trying to achieve that. Then we put them on a treadmill or a bike, and we start a very low level to figure out where they are, where they're comfortable. And we, periodically, there is a prescribed time frame before we increase the speed and the elevation of the treadmill. Almost every minute, every 2 minutes, asking the patient how they feel. There is a very nice scale where they can mark point to. And then when we see, either we see something on the equipment we have hooked up to the patient, or when the patient feels that they cannot go anymore, this is when we stop the test and we consider it a complete stress test. So what we're trying to do here is trying to unmask what's underneath that iceberg. So the chest pain or the discomfort that the patients see in their daily life, that's the tip of the iceberg. So a lot of people are asymptomatic when they have heart disease. Sometimes even the patients on a treadmill, in a stress test, in the lab, they don't feel anything. But yet we see something on the electric stuff, or we see something in the imaging. So this is what we're trying to do, is trying to reveal what's hidden.